Researchers at Bournemouth University have uncovered lost tracks at the world's oldest human footprint site in Laetoli, Tanzania.
It is an amazing site. It is the world's oldest footprint site. It's dated to 3.66 million years old. It's in northern Tanzania. And the site is important because it preserves the footprints of about three, possibly four, hominin individuals who walked across an ashy layer, and it preserves their footprint traces.
The tracks have been hidden in plain sight since being discovered in the 1970s, but new technology developed by the university will enable the study of these footprints to discover more about the site and our ancient ancestors.
There are two trackways, two sort of sets of prints. One beautifully preserved, one individual walking in the ash layer. And the other one has two individuals superimposed one on top of the other. So somebody walked and then somebody followed, and maybe even a fourth person followed on that same trail. So the study and the academic debate is all focused on the single trail, which is one individual. And they've ignored the composite tracks that are formed by these multiple individuals walking. And what we've been able to do for the first time is decouple the superimposed tracks of the second trackway and bring forward data that hasn't been available to contribute to the debate at the site.
That's amazing because it can tell us so much about the identity of the people who made the footprints. They are hominin ancestors. They're not humans like us. They belong to an ancestral species that we call Australopithecus afarensis. And because we have the identities of these different track makers now, we can look at aspects about their unique individual status, their height, their weight, how they moved and how they walked, which means this information is incredible for us because this is finding a new piece of data out of old footprints that haven't existed for years, and that's very exciting.
The software developed at BU has several practical applications, including helping police and forensics teams analyse footprints at crime scenes.
It's really a tool which brings many different tools in one, sort of. So in the old days, before we actually started working on this software, they would typically use half a dozen of different tools from different vendors, not necessarily compatible with each other, which would be very inefficient and sometimes also even costly. In this case, it's all in one package, one neat package, and it improves the efficiency of the work very, very, very greatly, and also allows them to do stuff that they couldn't do before because these tools just didn't exist. So one of the applications we're working right now is the forensic application, in which the law enforcement, you know, police and so on, are able to match prints of shot feet found on the crime scene with the database. It also facilitates research beyond the community, the forensic community. So it's not limited to human prints, for example. It's also dino prints and bird prints and so on. And we're working hard, to add new functionality and make the software better and more efficient.
This software product will be freeware. It'll be distributed widely to police and forensic services both in the UK and overseas, and hopefully will improve the way in which we investigate three-dimensional footwear evidence. So this study is about bare feet of ancient people, but the software can also be used for people wearing shoes, basically perhaps on the way to or from a crime scene in the future.